Hi there, scampers and stamping friends. This is Sharon White from Copycat Cards. I'm back again today to do another coloring video tutorial, but I wanted to talk about the images that I have found on Pinterest and have printed and use in cards. Yesterday or the day before, I did a search for some tropical coloring pages and found this, which I think will be really fun to color. And I found this image, and this one I printed two of, and I like that it has the pre-colored background. It'll be fun to add more color to the blossoms. And I love the funky drawing of this image. I think that'll be a lot of fun to color. And here's another one with a pre-colored background, that pretty salmon. And this is a smaller version of this one. I found this one first and thought it would be so pretty to color. It also already has, you know, a pale green wash over and behind it. But that doesn't matter. It'll cover up beautifully with Copics. And then I had shrunk it down to two images, smaller images that'll fit on a card. And I lightened up the black so that it's a paler gray and it'll be a little easier to color without so many bold black lines. So I liked that one. And then this is one that I printed. It originally was a full color, beautiful, richly colored tropical arrangement. And before I printed it, I lightened it up quite a bit so that the colors are very pale. And I think it'll be fun to boost the colors again with Copics. Here's another one with fun flowers. I like those. And I have my Power Poppy Let It Be Digi stamp from a couple of years ago, which I enlarged so that I could do two of them. And look at this. Ah, this is so beautiful. This is the image that I had used to make this one, I think. Yes. So yesterday I had done this one with Copics, but I printed it again and made it quite large, so the lines are very thick and very bold, and I have no idea what I would do with this after coloring it, but I think I might work on that today in this video. And here's another tropical image that's very large and bold. That should be awesome for coloring. Oh, and here is this one. This is the same image. I put two to a page. I started coloring it yesterday with Copics, and I think it's so very beautiful. And yeah, so I printed most of these on this paper pad. It's B paper artist marker paper, and I believe it says it's meant for pen and ink, technical pens and markers. A few minutes ago, I tried using my Zig markers with a little water on it, and it doesn't really behave correctly. So I stopped the video that I had started making with this, and we'll start again. So I guess I will use Copics, and I'm gonna go ahead and work on this giant one. And I really will try my best to keep this paper, you know, centered on my, oh, look what I did on my pseudo glass mat. I was digging through my craft room closet yesterday, and I came across my old rotary mat for cutting quilt pieces, and then this panel of glass from some random picture frame. I have no idea why I kept it, but it was up there and said, hey, I could put the two together. So I taped it down, and here I have my DIY glass mat. So I have no idea really what the benefit of it is, but I thought I'd give it a whirl, and there it is. All right, well, let's sit down and get started on this. I want you all to know how so very appreciative I am of all of the wonderful comments and encouragement that I've received, you know, as I've been posting some videos recently. It's so encouraging to me to know that, you know, my little hokey homemade videos, no editing, etc., are still of some value. I just really appreciate all the comments, and I always have the goal to be an encouragement to others and to inspire others. So if that's what has happened as a result of my videos, then yay. So I'm starting with BG78. This is bronze. And I really don't want to do this brushy thing with this. I don't know how to do really nice backgrounds, soft backgrounds with Copics. I don't know how you people are able to do that. I haven't learned that. So I'm still just kind of playing. I've been using Copics for about a year now, and I really do enjoy them. But I know there's a lot of technique to learn. Okay, I'm going to put that down for the moment and pick up BG72 Ice Ocean. And go over that a little bit. For some reason, I really like filling in my background first. I don't know if it's because it's so satisfying to fill it in, or if because by having the background filled, then the overall image doesn't seem so daunting when it's all just floating there and, you know, white space, all the pieces and parts that look can be overwhelming. I think that might be the main reason, but I do love backgrounds. I think a beautiful background is such an important part of a card or a project. And there's so much you can do with backgrounds that really enhance your work. I don't like how this line is showing. I don't know if I just have to keep adding on more and more layers of this other color, but I'm going to leave that for the moment and go back in to these little nooks and crannies with bronze. And I realize that I might be out of the view of the camera. So if you hear me get up every now and then, it's because I'm checking that. Yeah, that's good. It's a very, very cold day today here in Vermont, although the sun is shining, so that's a huge bonus. It's so funny to read everyone's comments about the weather and how, you know, all around the United States and so many other states, people are dealing with the same stuff we're dealing with here. You know, random snowstorms and ice storms and high winds and things like that. I love our community of stampers and card makers. Being a part of it has brought such joy and richness to my life. And I've made some pretty sweet friends in our community. All right, back with the bronze. This is where you might want to fast forward. So boring. Whoops. You know, I've been doing a lot of coloring in the style of Alex Siberia recently with all her very awesome dots. But I don't know if I'm going to do that with this one. I don't know if I'm going to just keep this, you know, all realistic, or if I'll get a wild hair and decide to switch it up and be artsy fartsy. Guess we'll find out, huh? All right. Now, I kind of like the idea of adding texture, not necessarily with the series of dots, although it looks like I'm dotting, but more of just thick, shorter, chunky little brush strokes. Yeah, I like that. Add some more over here and blend out that line. I should turn on some music. Except every time I have music in my videos, then I'm not sure if it's just YouTube that doesn't let me post the parts of the video where there's, you know, licensed music playing, or I can't remember if it had done that on some of my videos I made for and posted on our stamping Facebook groups. But, you know, you'd hear it for a few minutes and then the music would just disappear because, you know, they didn't want you listening to licensed music without their permission. Well, hello, what's the radio? I always have music playing in my stamp room when I'm working.
All right, let's blend that out a little bit. You know what? I'm going to stop doing that. I'm going to stop working on that for the time being and do some of these just so that you don't have to sit and watch the whole boring process of that going on. Oh, you know what? Let's do some. I have a lot of shades of pink, you know, a lot. I don't even know how many Copic markers I have. But let's do some of this. This one is RV19 Red Violet. Okay, whoops, this one. Get my little paper here for checking the color. This one is RV25 Dog Rose Flower. Okay. It's a little bit fluorescentish, if that's a word. But by the time I've added all the layers of colors that I typically do, I don't think it'll look fluorescent-like. So what is the purpose of a glass mat over, say, just the brown kind of craft mat that we all had for so long? Not quite sure what the benefit of the glass mat is. Okay, enough of that one. Now what's this color? RV06 Cerise. Oh, that's very fluorescent. I don't want that. Let's try RV02 Sugared Almond Pink. It's a lighter shade of pink. I love how the lighter markers tend to act like almost like a colorless blender. Alexa, turn on Pandora. Easy listening.
Danielle Nicole Radio from Pandora.
This is one of my favorite news stations, Danielle Nicole Radio. But I'm afraid I won't be able to leave this on the radio. I mean on the background. They're gonna remove it. But you know what? Let's listen to it for a little bit. R81 Rose Pink. I love finding an artist, music artist, who has a husky, kind of gorgeous voice, and probably two of my favorites are Bonnie Raitt and Susan Tedeschi. But this is somebody that I found recently. Her name is Danielle Nicole. I'm going to add some yellow. This is actually cream, YR21. Okay, that's pretty. That kind of added a cool dimension. What am I going to do in the center? I think I'm going to start with some mustard, Y26. And use my dark brown E49 for these little jobbies. And a little chamois, E35. Hope I'm still in the camera frame. And then I'm going to use this chamois to deepen these little shadows. Nice. I hope the music's not a distraction. Alexa, turn down the volume. I'm going to start my leaves with E33 sand. Good. Okay. Now I'm going to use this color, YR65 Atal. I don't know if that's how you say it. And I'm going to add a little shot here as well. This is why I don't list all of my colors I use. I have no idea what colors I'm going to use, and by the time I have finished with one of my projects, I've probably used every color there is. Okay. And then there's this lovely rose salmon, RO2. That's kind of a paler color. That's similar to what I just used. I'm just kind of swiping it on over the others. Okay. And now I'm going to use some G82 Spring Dim Green. Okay, and then I'm going to use some YGO3, which is yellow green, and that's a little brighter. And just add a touch of that at the tips. Okay, that was kind of random. I'm also going to add a little pale yellow right on top of all of that. I think my pale yellow is running out. Looking very pale. Darn it. I don't have any refills for my Copics. Okay, there's that. Did I already do cream? Oh. I love how each color just like changes the look a little bit, deepens it. Probably shouldn't be making these all to look exactly alike, but whatever. I think they're beautiful. Okay. I'm not quite thrilled with this. I'm gonna deepen it up even more with Garnet R39. Mainly in the shadows. Then I'll blend it out with another color. I'm going to blend it out with what's Bougainvillea R43. Yeah. Oops. Eh, that might have been too much down there. In these little dips right here is where I'm putting a little of the darker color. This is mostly dark. I'm just gonna fill that right in. Yeah, I like that. Here and then down this little side and here as well. See what I mean about layers and layers? So gorgeous. All right. I'm gonna start this little one over here with actually dark red R89. We'll jump right in with a dark one. I'm just gonna leave those for now. And then I'll add a little of this R39 garnet. Just a teeny. Then I will go in with the R43 Bougainvillea. I hope you can still see. And then, what did I use? Oh man, I used a bunch of these red pinks. I'm gonna use a little of this RVO2 sugared almond pink. Oh, I think that's a blossom. I mean a petal. So let's go ahead and add some color to it. That was dark red. Here's garnet, extended up a little bit. Here's bougainvillea. There. Okay. A little pale yellow. A little cream. Remember that? Beautiful. I'm going to leave that at that for now. I'm going to come in with this dark brown and go over these little stamen thingies or whatever they're called. Very lightly do that, and then back with the chamois. A little more chamois because I can't help myself. Okay, I'm just gonna soften that a little bit. Let's use a little eggshell, just as a blender. That's good. Okay, so what am I gonna do with that? I guess I'll just use, I haven't used pale olive yet. It's one of my favorites. I'm gonna add a swipe to these. And then let's use a little willow. That's a little darker. We'll stick that under there, a little under there. I'm not loving that color. How about some pistachio? I don't know my colors that well. I'm still kind of learning them, but that's good. Okay, let me check the orientation. Still pretty good. All right, I feel like this needs something to jazz it up. So this time I'm gonna start on this blossom with Tuscan Orange, which is YR27. This will be my base color. And then I'll probably end up adding a little of this over here. Because it'll sort of make it look like these flowers are in the same plant, but with some variations. So that this one doesn't look exactly like that one. And I'm drawing in the darkest color, you know, along the edges of where the petals kind of overlap one another. You'd add a little swipe in there. Okay. So that's good for a start on that one. And then I'm going to go over it with YR24 Pale Sepia. I always use this one after the other one.
See, I'm working kind of quickly now. Then I'm going to use this one to bring over here, just like the other one, for kind of the same reason, so that it has a little similarity to this other big blossom. Just touches. All right, and then this one I'm going to, I'm not sure that I'm done with those colors. I'm gonna come in with rose salmon. So start introducing some of the pink back in. Actually, I'm not going to use that quite yet. I'm going to jump in with the Bougainvillea. Probably nobody else colors these things the way I do. I'm kind of wacky. I don't know what I'm doing. Mainly just goofing off, trying out things to see what'll happen. The proper trained Copic people be like, "What? What is she doing? That's not how you do it." Alexa, turn down Pandora. Alexa, turn down Pandora. There. So you see what I mean about giving them similar hues, but they don't look exactly like one another. Okay, because this one has hues of the orangey and the other one has hues of pink. Man, I cannot stop. Stop, Sharon, stop. Okay. I guess I'll see what just plain old RV11 pink looks like. That's pretty pale. I'll just kind of do a little base for some of these edges. I don't want to fill in my little white spots though. I want enough of my white showing for my little highlights. Okay. I'm going to hit this with a little of the pale yellow, which actually I don't love, so no more of that. Let's try the cream. What will the cream do? Cream is just going to add more to the yellowy, orangey. So really what I want is more pink. So, let's put that away. What does rose mist look like? That's a little darker.
So interesting how a lighter color, when you put it on top of all the other layers, it still deepens the color overall. See that? I'm gonna let that be for the time being and do this again with E49 dark brown. Just putting the dark brown at the base of those thingies. Using the dark brown to outline those lines and then a few little dots. And then the chamois, yeah. Remember how I'd kind of gone into the little crannies with this one to shade and deepen? Let's see what happens if I do it here. I'm a little hesitant about doing it because it just adds to the whole orange overall look, and I don't really want to enhance that anymore. I need some more pink and a little bit darker pink. So let's see about this Cerise RV06. Oh, that was that kind of hot pink one. Well, it's definitely more pink. Holy cow. Sure, I love that. Oh, there goes Bear. Yipping and yapping. Bears are a little chorky. He's pretty cute. He's usually in here behind me on his blanket that he's dragged in. But I guess the couch is more comfortable this morning. I'm going to blend this out with a lighter color. I'm blending out with R83 Rose Mist. Okay, that's good. Whoops, I have this one down here. Let's do this one again. This was, I started it with dark red R89. And added a little bit of garnet. Oops. And then my bougainvillea, I believe, which is R43. And I had added a little bit of pale yellow and then some cream. That's pretty. I didn't add much cream here. Let's add a little more. That looks good. And then the dark brown, whoops, just to beef up those little stamen again, and some little lines, a few little dots, and the chamois. Just like the other one. All right, now I think that these leaves look too much in the salmon-y color family. So I'm going to change them a little bit and make them a little greener with some YG95 pale olive. Okay, and then the sand. No, not the sand. Let's add some cream. Just to make those colors a little more vivid. And this is like a completely different random leaf. It doesn't look anything like the rest of them, although I guess it could be this one. So that means I've got to build this up. Start with some chamois. Add some of this olive green. A little bit of cream. And that atoll. That's good. Okay, so what would be, maybe I'll just leave those kind of white, add a little gray for shading. So I will continue with my background. Alexa, forward.
I'm not sure what went wrong.
Forward. Alexa, forward.
Yeah.
Did we already hear this song? Okay. She's across the room. Looks all fine. Tell me why the last time I felt that perfume, it was all over you. Maybe doing something wrong. I kind of like this wiggly jiggly way of doing the background for a little added texture. I'll try to blend the between the two colors and let this Ice Ocean BG72 kind of soften that bronze. Doing something wrong. Now I want to add a little cream. Just as a little added dimension. And I'm just kind of, you know, jiggling it on. Okay. And I think I'm also going to add an element of purple. That might be too light. It's a little lighter than I want. What's Wisteria? That's almost as light. Wisteria and shades of lavender make a nice shading. That's still a little too light. I think blueberry might be too light. Let's try ash lavender. That might be too dark. Nope, that's probably perfect. That's great for shadows. Just adding a little more texture. Not so much Alex Siberia's dots as just little jaggedy marks. Like it. Okay. That's good. Do I want anything else? Do I want a little pink? This is called Smoky Purple, RV93. Yeah. It's kind of more of the same, kind of a pinky. Sure, why not? Okay. I'm going to add a little more of the cream. Not much. I like it showing a little bit on the edges. Okay, that's all I'm doing with that. Now, the only other thing I might do is use Abyss Green to just deepen up these little shadows a little bit. I'm not sure, though. I don't really want to. If I do that, do I want to blend it out with this? I don't know if I want to do that. I might not really need that. Maybe I'll just use this in these little teeny nooks and crannies. Now I'm doing little dots, very subtle. That's using the Abyss Green. And blending them out a little bit with this ice ocean. Because I don't want them to look noticeably like dots, but more like just little tiny texture. So, yeah, I think I'm pretty much, you know, almost finished with this, except for these little doodads. So I'm going to end the video. Thank you for watching. I hope that it's not been agonizingly long. But I do hope it will be a help. Really? My phone says low battery. I think it was still recording, so I'm just going to hold this up. Here we go. There's my Copic mess, and that. Thanks for watching. I'll see you on a different day.